Hi, good evening, Nana here. In this one, we are going to see category level assignments for a local make. Go there. I'm going to share my screen. So let me first of all get the item. So it's a make receive and ship. This is the item which I'm going to create now. I'm going to take it up. And then go there. Let me get take it up. Just look. I go there. Go to the product management. Before going to the what happens, you have to first of all create the category actually. It does not first create the category and then afterwards come over here. Go to the set of element events. Click on it. And then go to the search. It's manage functional area cutup. Go there. And then you'll now go to the planning area and then get the category. Click on the function and then here I will know. Sort it up and down. So it's not coming. Go to the planning catalog and then I don't get a new catalog. So click on plus now. I'm now keeping the item name itself as a category name. And so just for easy understanding, and then the category code will be coming automatically. Click on the description. Is a make receive ship. Okay, click on OK. So by which the category is now created. Click on save and close. This is now complete. So let's now go there and then get the item. Click on that. We are in the process of creating an item. Go there. Click on it and then go there. And then go to the product management and then go to the product information management. And then let alone create the item. And then we are going to assign it to this planning category also. Click on it and then click on create item. Let alone do it in the visions master of 000. And then I'll put the root item class over here. So root item class. And then click on OK now. Here I'm not going to have a bill now, fine, or a single level bill will be created actually. Paste it over here and then click on the description. And then afterwards go down and then I'll know what the specs and then make it as what? As a make item now. Fine. So manufacturing is okay, fine. WIP is okay. Fine. Go to the sales and order management and I'll make it as what? Back to back as this now. Back to back as this. And then you go to the planning and then make it as a make item. This is a make item actually. Fine. So make a change to make now. You know, make. Go down, go down, go down. And then here, what I'm going to go there. And then calculate ATP is yes, no. I'm going to give a processing rate as well. Sufficient of that. Purchasing. We are not going to be bothered anymore. What happens? I'm not going to give a this price. If you're going to interface to purchasing, then it's a must know. Otherwise, what happens? The requisitions will not be created. No. And then here, you go there and then give a save. No. At this stage, what happens? You're going to save. So once we're in the save, what happens? We're not create a structure. Actually. So it's a, it will not have any components at all. But what happens? I'm not going to make it as a bomb. So the item has to exist as a bomb as well as what happens, a routing also has to exist. Then only what happens, it will be interfacing into manufacturing. You go to the structures and then you create a structure. So then go to the actions and then go to select map and go there along create. You know, go to create, click on create. So we'll be creating it and make it as a primary now. So it's a primary. So click on what happens, click on OK, that's sufficient. Okay? There is no, no need to add any details actually. Okay? There will not be any component on this. And then give a save now. Give a save. And then we'll now assign it to the child org. So the structure is created. Fine. Go to the associations and then we'll now create the child org. Associate the child org. Go to the actions and then we'll select an add. So we'll now associate to 002. I'm going to associate. Fine. 002 is Atlanta. And go to click on apply and then click on the fine. Let us now save and close and then what happens? You query. So go down and then save and close. Now query this item and then I will know what happens. The common the structure from the master to child. Click on it now. Go to the browser here. Be calling it. Paste it over here and find enter. So you know, go to the child or find the bottom one is a child or and go to click on it. Comment it to the child. Click on. So you know, comment the child. So go there. You go to the structures and then right? Make a comment. Go to the actions and then go to create from common now. And then the top, what happens? I go to the operations of the organization now. Operations the one. Choose it now. And then item is what you paste it and then it will long come now. Result we are having a structure over here. Click on okay now by which order, but the commoning is now getting done now. So a concurrent will be running for commoning. That much is sufficient. So we'll wait for some time till we create or what happens you go there. We have to create our work definition also. So work definition is nothing but a routing actually. So we'll wait now. Go there, go to the home page, and then we'll now go to the supply chain execution and then go to the work definition. So work definition is the one where what happens, we are going to create a routing now. So it takes some time for the concurrent to complete so that what happens, then only it will be visible there, this place now. Click on it. And then we'll now go to the work definition area, manage work definitions, and then I will now give a plus and then page it. So I am in the 002 R, now find remember. I mean the 002. Now click on plus now. And then if you put the item over here, click on plus. I will now put the item over here. Item and then give a tab now. The structure name primary has to come now. It has not yet come because what happens the concurrent has not yet completed. So we have to wait for some time now. So we'll go there and then try to create a work definition. Click on plus now. And then paste the item over here and then give a tab. So we're going to give it up. The primary is coming from the. So click on next and then what happens? If you go there here, we have to give the name now. Click on the name. And the type is coming, version of everything is coming. You click on next now. You go to the next level. There, what happens? We have to attach the standard operations and routing now. So I'm not attaching anything, and then I will now give a save and edit and it's all there. Nothing, no operations there. And click on save and edit now. So yeah, minimum of one operation is required for a valid work definition. They are saying enables it is not so. We can very well save it actually. And it needs at least one operation. That is what they say. Maybe it, the manufacturing concepts might have got changed actually. A01 without even having anything, any operations, we can very well save the whatever the routing. So I will now put something of my wedding. And then I will now go up and then I will not attach any components of my click on save and edit now. Save and edit. And then it goes and then it will ask you which component you want to add now. And the bill itself is not having any components as such now. So we'll now go to the next stage and then we'll now simply give a save and close. Remember, the system, the item has to remain as a bill as well as in routing. So it's not showing you something, man. Make receive and check is an item or what? I'm not sure about it. The component actually fine. I've not added anything at all, man. Give a save and close. That's it. The building operation is there. No components are attached to it. You know, so by which what happens, we are now completed the creation of a routing actually. So if you go and then query it, what happens? You give it app, you give it app, and then click on search, it has to be available. So only a routing can be basically interfaced to manufacturing and what has done. So we have done what happens, the item creation, the structure creation, the definition, and then what happens, we'll now have a stock also. We'll have a stock of two. We'll now see how it's going to work because I have not tested it actually. I'm not going to test for the first time for that. So I will now go to the inventory management and I'll now keep a stock of two on this organization and then I will now make a work order of five actually. So whether the system is sensing the two or not, I'm going to see. So I will now go to the place. I will now go to the inventory and then click on the create miscellaneous transaction. Drop it down and then choose the miscellaneous result. And then populate the item over here, account over here. So click on search and then pop it down some junk amount on populating it. Click on OK. And then this is yes, no. And then click on plus. And then I will now populate the item over here. Fine. Let us now have two quantities over here. Fine. Click on it. I will now give two quantities. Item is not available in 002. Come on. I am in which org? Oh God. I am in the wrong org actually. Fine. You cancel. Click on yes. Click on change job. Go there. Click on get the next transaction and change the org. I have to be 002 because the item has been assigned to only 002. Enter it. Okay. Now I'll now get the organization. So go there and then we'll now make a miscellaneous result. Create miscellaneous result transaction. Drop it down and then make a miscellaneous result. And then I'll now copy the account over here. Search. Go there and then click on OK. OK. Now it's populated now. So click on OK. Click on yes. Click on plus now and then put the item over here. Item has to come in the cheap. Click on it and then I will now put it in the stores. I will now have keep a quantity of two. So when I make a manufacturing requirement for five, it has to send this two. That is what I want now. I'm not sure about that. No, send the two or not. I will now go on and get the sales order for five quantities. The two has to be sensed actually. So having done all these things, what happens? We go there and then collect it. Get it collected. Then only what happens? It'll be available in the supply chain planning area. Click on the plan inputs on the electric collect. Yeah, collect it. So go there, click on it and then collect planning data. And then please always use a targeted one because net change is not exactly working for me. I don't know. So go there and then charge it. And then here I'm now going to collect items. And then work definitions, work structures and definitions. Actually, item structures we bring in, the work definition will be coming automatically. So okay, item structure and work definition. And then the catalogs also I'm going to collect because whatever I know, introduced one extra one on the catalog and go there. And then you go to the supply chain planning and then I'll now bring the on and also. So we have created a catalog also. So a category has been created. So I now brought the catalog also. So on a targeted way, you collect it. Since only there are minimal, it won't be taking a longer time now. So click on submit. No matter. So once it was running, what happens? You go there and then query after the running, go there, click on it and then keep query. What happens? It has to show me the item again. Right? So we'll now wait for some time and then afterwards query. We'll wait for some time. So a significant amount of load entity concurrence have already completed now. Fine. We go there and then query. Fine. This is sufficient for what happens? The item coming into the planning area. Fine. Go there, click on it and then click on search now. You now see that what happens? Yeah, item has come. Item has arrived over there. Fine. We'll now go on and make our first setup on this now. Fine. You go there, click on the home icon, and then you go to the order management, and then go to the global order promising. The first setup I'm going to make. Go to this place, and then I go to the manage ATP sets, ATP rules now. Let me query my A01 now. I've already created one for the previous exercise. So I will choose the ATP01 rule now, edit, and then here, what happens? I'm going to add the next category. We'll come plus one. Let me add a category. Drop it down and then choose the category. Category is the least one and then the most one. And remember, ATP rule only will now consider only one level of assignment, actually, one level of a rule actually. Whereas only the assignment sets, everything will be considered. Here, what happens is only one. So if you have a category level as well as item level, category will be ignored and then item level will be considered. If you have item organization, everything will be ignored and then that will be considered. So I'm now giving it a leaf level. So I click on it. I'll paste this and then give a tab now. You'll see that it's coming. It's not coming. So A0123 has come. Fine. Give a save now. Fine. I'll see whether it is working or not. Fine. There's no save. Save and close. By which what happens? We have now completed the ATP rule, and then we have already seen the criteria over here. So the criteria are what? All of them are selected, and then here I have now given user defined as 100 days, and then here also user defined as 100 days on the ATP time plans. So click on save and close. The first activity is now complete. We go there. And then we'll now have a look at the sourcing rule. Now click on it. We'll now go to the what's called manage sourcing rules. We already have created one sourcing rule for manufacturing. Actually, we'll now use the same one. So it's what a global manu sourcing rule now. Fine, at the 00 to R, fine, click on it. There's a local sourcing rule. Fine, click on it. So again, a local sourcing rule at 00 to R. So it is going to be manufactured at this place. So we have this. So we will now use this A01 manu SR1 for our exercise. Fine, click on it. And then we already have what one transfer to customer as a global level. We have this now. Fine. Here we have already specified all the orgs over here. Now, fine. So all the orgs is not in the transfer. Sorry. Ship to fine. I was going to say transfer to this one A01 transfer to customer one. Fine, click on edit now. So it says what happens. You know, going to have it. So if you have 50 orgs, make 50 entries now. Fine, and we have seen the ranking also is working very perfectly. So you do it accordingly as far as 1, 2, and 3. Only we are going to ship only from 2. We can use the same one. Thank you. Cancel. So this completes the sourcing rule creations. We go there and then click on this now. Fine, click on it and then we'll now go to the assignment sets. Fine, go to the manage assignment sets. Manage assignment sets here again. We'll now query A01 now. So it's now pointing to my assignment set 1 now. I click on it and then I'll add one more line. For manufacturing, we already have a global shipping that we have seen for a normal item. Fine, that. So it has got all the 3 orgs. They will be used for shipping to the customers now. Fine, click on plus now. Then I'll now make them local. So I will now go for a category and organization now. Fine, category and organization. The organization is 002. Then give a tab. The category, we'll now paste it over here and then give a tab now. Just to come up. So go there. There's A0123 and then click on search now. Fine. So here sometimes it doesn't come, then what happens? You again go for a targeted search now. So when you make a local, what happens? It is not coming basically. Fine. Here yeah, you're doing it, not coming. So if you make a targeted search, it came. So that way, what happens? I'm not getting a negative setting now. I will now make a targeted search only for the categories. The categories, I don't know. We already done a targeted search only. I don't know why it's not coming. We'll again make a search of the same. The category has to come now. So click on it. And then go to the collect planning data. I think I've done the targeted one, OPS, and then targeted, and then catalogs only. Ever not correct. Catalogs. Is there anything on the categories? You know, see? Is there anything on the categories? I don't find anything on the categories, basically. Geographies. Maybe first one must be categories and the next one will be item or something like that. There is some order basically. Over there. If it doesn't come, I'll be collecting everything actually. We'll click on it. Supply chain. And then here on hand, purchase orders, requisition sales orders, work order supplies. Okay. So nothing seems to be really very specific. The targeted one, and then let me collect and then wait for it. So click on submit now. I'm collecting it now. So let me wait for some time and then afterwards what happens, I have to go and then see whether I'm able to get in this place, in this one, in this place. Where is the one here? I don't know. So let us now wait for this current to complete now. I actually made a mistake here in the product management. I'm going to the product information management. Go to the browse items. I'll paste the item over here. Click on search. So what I did is, I have forgotten to assign the category over here in this place. Go there and then go to the categories. The planning catalog has not been assigned to my category. That is why it was not coming. So I did it and then I made a collection. Now it came. So the planning catalog was something else. So that has to be assigned to this category actually. Then only what happens, the collection is giving. So this is a mistake actually from the side. Now let's go there and then continue on this now. So I go to home and then I go there. And then now go to order management and then go to the global order policy. Go further here and then here. And then go to the manager assignment sets. Query my assignment set of 301 entering. Select and then click on edit now. So click on plus. I will now go for item on category organization assignment. Go there. 024, go there. A0123 and then give a tab. So 002 the tab. And then here it's A0123 and then give a tab. It's coming. The sourcing rule and then the local one. So it's a A01 mano at 002. So the manual sourcing rule. And that's it. So we have completed the assignment set over here. So give a save and close. Now let us collect it again. So we'll again verify whether it is okay or not. It doesn't verify it. So we have a org level and then category level and then assignment. The cancel. So it's there. So let's go and then collect it now. Go to the home. Supply chain planning and then planning inputs. We will only collect the order orchestration reference objects, nothing else is required also. So for the connection. We get the OPS and then go down. Order orchestration reference object and go to that. I think it's this one. So it's not done. So let us wait for the concurrent to complete now. So the collection of the order orchestration reference object is completed over there. And then we'll now do a reference start. Now run it for all now. Submit it. We'll wait for this refresh and start to complete. So we will now go inside and then we'll now create the sales order. This in the collection. We go to the order management and then here we go to the order management. Click on create order. So we have a on hand quantity of 2 now. There's one business unit. So it's a computer services and adults. We'll now paste the item over here now. A0123 and then your tab. So it says it's in stock. So we have a 2 quantities. If you go for sort of the 5 quantities over here now, in your tab. It says low inventory available too. So availability is only 2 and then so you're asking 5. It doesn't matter, fine. We have to manufacture the remaining 3 now. Click on add. And then go there and then tell the date on which you want now. The day 22nd, I remember. 22nd is the date I'm putting it. And then click on submit by which the sales order will be accepted. So this has to go into manufacturing actually. It is getting submitted. Click on OK and then you'll know. Have this progress of the do now. The control refresh. Depending on the community processing. So good actions and then go to switch to fulfillment view. Get control refresh. So So we go to the fulfillment model. So the ordered quantity is now 5. So click on it and see how the progression takes place. It is not scheduled. And then it has to go as a supply request as an the scheduling is complete now. So should link request supply has now gone started now. Click on refresh. The pass is completed and then we're going ahead. Supply request is complete now. If I click on the fulfillment lines, on how to look at it now. Whether the SCO, supply chain orchestration, is now complete or not. You have to get a back-to-back order over here now. The orchestration process. This is now progress to awaiting shipping without any issues now. Know where it stopped. So click on the fulfillment lines again. Then go down. Yeah, the supply order number has come now. So click on refresh. The order number is awaiting supply. Can click on it now. No, okay. And remember, a bill and routing are a must actually. If the work definition is not made, it will never be interfaced to manufacturing at all. Now, this is now going upon. So now the line has got split. Yes. Inside it is getting split now. And one end is 2 now. So what I was only for 3 quantities, the order is now made. It is a basically available is a make order. Fantastic. I was wondering about where exactly this will be there actually. So click on it now. So only 3 quantities have been interfaced to manufacturing now. So it's now saying awaiting work order creation. Awaiting work order creation. Then we go down. You can now see on the make, you'll be having one now. Click on the make. Then click on refresh now. So the assignments, now I did it category level. So if you have plenty of items, what happens, you can even go for category. If all of them falls in and what happens are two or three categories, you can do it now. So you only have to make a small R&D on how many ways you can now do the GOP promising to the customers now. And the assignment sets level. So if you're coming, I'm going to click on it. So if you go to the execution documents, it has to come now. Fine. You go to the orchestration plan, you go to the site, keep a cursor on the screen. Work order is not under creation actually. And if you go to the execution, you know, fine. The work order number, fine. Okay, Tata underscore 1052 has now become now. Fine. So let us go there and then execute the order now. Fine. Let's duplicate it and let us execute the order. So you go to the supply chain execution and then here what happens, you go to the work execution. Click on it. And then here, I will now go to what? You will go to the review dispatch list. You click on the review dispatch list. Click on it. And then I will now choose my work area. Fine. My work area, I think I had to choose all. Because I don't know in which work area I've created. Is it on my work area? Okay, I'll select all. And then click on search and find Tata 1052 is the order number actually. So you can now see, yeah, Tata 1052 has come here. And is in which work area? I don't know. So you expand it and then what happens? You complete it. It doesn't have any what's called routing at all. Fine. We have one routing, of course. We have one routing. So it was asking already. So complete to the details is what I'm going to give up. And click on it. And then click on complete details. And in between, what happens, you'll now go and then see how much has been interfaced to sales order. Okay? It is a new process. Okay? These 2 quantities have been interfaced to sales order, or the shipping execution or not. I would like to have a look at it now. So right click on it and then go there. Right click on the duplicate now. You will know the shipping execution, you know, have a look at it, whether it has been interfaced or not. Yeah, you go there, go to the supply chain execution, they go to the inventory management. Customer is already in stock now. Go there, click on it. And then you go to the shipments, manage shipment lines, and I'm going to make a check of it. So here, what is the sales order number? 98361, I think. 98361. 98361 or yeah, 98361. So no query for it. 98361 is the one, and go there. And then I will put before date. Some date. I'm putting it on. Okay, I'm gonna click on search now. So we'll see whether anything has come here or not. Search it. That means what? It is not getting interfaced at all to shipping execution till the score gets completed. Only when the manufacturing gets completed, it will be coming at you. So we'll again make a check of it. So order number is 98361. So the two numbers is not getting interfaced, and then it gets done only after some time. Now, it is not getting interfaced to shipping execution at all. Even the two quantities are ready for this. No, fine. It is now waiting for the score to complete. Then only I think it will be coming. So let us now complete this process. So in this place, if you go on and see, if you refresh it now, and then go down, and then you click on the supply order number, you can see what goods are available there, two quantities, and then three have been gone for manufacturing actually. So it's not showing you. But the goods available is not getting, goods partially available, the same, but it is not getting interface to shipping execution at all. Even though here it says what is awaiting shipping, but it has not gone to the shipping execution, maybe. That is because when I made a search, what happens, I'm not getting it. Oh God, the organization is wrong. So let me change the organization from 002. Oh God, we are not having an access to this org, you know. Since it is a manual org, we have to provide the access also. Data access has to be provided. We go to set up a maintenance and then provide the data access for it. You can search manage data access for users. So I will now give a plus and then I add the read access to it. It's the SEM00 instructor. So for the what's called shipping, I need it now. Shipping is not having a role also. That is another thing, because what happens is not having a generic role on this now. We have a OUSCM role, and then for the inventory arc, inventory organization for the 002. And then I click on save and close now. No, done. So click on done, and then I will go it again. Go there. And then you go to the supply chain execution, and then you go to the inventory management, and then have a look at it. Probably it might have got interfaced it. Go there. The shipment lines, and then change the OR. Click on change OR. We will put 002. Organization 002. We click on search now. So I think we have to add the inventory manager role, and then afterwards give a data access. Now let me do it now. Let me log in through another user now. Ava.clark. Ava Clark. Ava.clark. And then we'll see whether she has got the access to your inventory now. Supply chain execution. Inventory management. Okay, you know, click on the inventory management. And then there, you go here. Click on shipments and manage shipment lines. Okay. It's not coming at all. It doesn't matter. You can even leave it as it's now. So in this place, we'll now go there and see all this thing. Okay, go there on the order number 98361. So 98361. Before. Some dates I'm putting in. Okay. And click on search now. It's for all the org actually. So we will now see whether the two quantities have been interfaced into the shipping execution or not. Yes, it's there. So that means what, it has only come now. So item is there. So the two quantities are interfaced, but the only thing is the remaining three has not come. Right. It is not basically five it is not showing. Okay, fine. The entire five it is showing. So if I do and then pick collect, what happens? It will automatically get back ordered. We can see that we will not try to order the shipments. Let me do it now. Only two are available ready-madely now. So if I ship it, what happens? It will be getting back ordered. So I'm including a shipment. What if the shipment is completed out now? Save and close. No day. And then query this one. And then manage shipment lines. And then what the number? 98361 before and then put some date and then it'll launch the ship confirm directly. So click on search now. You go to actions and then go to pick release now. And this will be basically what it will be splitting the line into 2 and 3 now. Fine, 2 is already shipped, but the 3 will be getting back ordered because we don't have any detail now. It's not in manufacture actually. So we ready to list. It has to get split into 2 now. Yeah, it has got split into 2. So 2 is now staged and then 3 are back ordered. So they're waiting for the manufacturing to get completed. So in this place, if you go the review dispatch list, you go there and quick complete it. Well, you quick complete it. So by which the manufacturing is now getting completed for the 3 quantities now. So by making a quick complete of this one, you can now see that you have completed the quantity of 3 into operation 10, the sub-inventory. Completed sub-inventory has gone there. And then the work order number of Tata 1052. So this will be getting interfaced into SCO now. Fine, the SCO will be getting updated. Okay. You go back over here now. This place, if you go down and then go to the fulfillment area, it was awaiting shipping now. And click on it. And then if you click on the goods partial available, now it will be quickly available. So refresh it now. So in production, it is now saying in production. And then afterwards, you go down and you can even see on the make. You keep your cursor on this now. Can you see there's a work order? So it's now released to production. So we have to find out that what happens. The completion has to be coming. Work order is not completed. Right? Work order completion. The tick mark has to come now. So wait for it. So we have completed it. Manufacturing is not completed. So yeah, the tick mark has come. So once the tick mark has come, what happens? You can now say the status is what work order complete. And what it's saying. So work order complete is one. So it's perfectly done. So you know, keep it done and then come out of it. And you can now see that what happens in the main line, you'll be having what? So goods are available. Because initially goods was partially available. Now 2 and 3 has got become totally as 5 now. So now everything would have been interfaced to shipping. Fine. If you go there in this place, go there. I will now open up the back ordered line and then I will now auto create shipment for this now. The shipment number will be getting created. And so we'll now go there and then under the pick release, that will also be getting staged. Since they are available for it, now I'm going to click on it and then go to actions and then go to launch pick release. So that's now getting done now. No, if you go on the inquiry, it will be staged. Also, it is not stitched. So this completes the manufacturing process, and then after you go and then go ahead and then do the shipping, it will be done. So the real what happens? The skill which you have to have is what in this area. If you go to this global order promising, go there and then click on. Your assignment sets and then query the A01 now. So we go there and click on edit now. How many ways we can now do these things? There are plenty of ways to So you have to make an R&D and then see which best suits your customers, and accordingly the assignments that has to be made. That is where your real skill lies. You go through the what's called your GOP documentation, it will be explaining a lot about it. So it's a very powerful tool, but then it meets the customer's needs in a very proper manner. So with this, what happens, we conclude this session on this back-to-back week using category assignments and then in the GOP roadmap. We'll now see you on next video on another topic. Bye for now. Nana here.